Welcome to the course on experimental stress analysis. Experimental methods are crucial to verify designs for performance evaluation and also to certify for human safety. Formal training in experimental methods is essential to achieve this. After a course on introduction to solid mechanics, one is trained to understand stress or strain at a point, but fails to comprehend the variation of these quantities over the field. In an optical technique, one instantly gets whole field information of a particular parameter dictated by the physical principle exploited in the technique. As part of this course, you will learn what is the physical principle behind an experimental technique and what is the basic information you get out of this. In this course, we would exhaustively cover versatile techniques like photoelasticity and strain gauges. Photoelasticity is an experimental technique that can be used easily, and one can understand nuances of stress analysis and concepts in solid mechanics easily. Concepts such as Sein-Vinon principle, free surface, etc., can be understood very easily. I would also provide you discussion on transmission photoelasticity, exposure to photoelastic coatings, and a glimpse of what digital photoelasticity is. Strain gauge is a widely used technique. However, in my observation, it is also a technique abused widely due to lack of training in that approach. Strain gauge pasting or selection is not trivial as one thinks it to be. One has to have a formal training, and also one should be trained on correction factors on how to interpret the experimental strain data for proper interpretation. As part of this course, I would be explaining under given circumstances what is an ideal experimental technique to use. Please make a note of this, and there are no formal methods on how to identify a technique for a given situation. One learns it by various applications, and this will be covered through the entire stretch of the course. So, you need to make a copy of it, and then this will be asked in your assignments and in exams. Please start working on the first assignment on review of solid mechanics to understand the course better. My e-book on experimental stress analysis would be used, and fortunately, it has rich animations that would make a teaching class into a laboratory for easy understanding of the experimental methods. And your cooperation in the participation in the course is essential for you to learn, and I expect that we have a purposeful time in the weeks to come to learn this course. Thank you.